Hey guys, and welcome back to the Gerbil Vine. Thank you all so much for clicking on this video, and if you haven't already, please hit that like and subscribe button so that the gerbils and I can continue spreading around good care here on YouTube. So getting a new pet is such an exciting time. I remember being a kid, and anytime that my family would be getting a new cat or a dog, I literally could not sleep the entire night before. I was so excited to meet it, just to have something new to love. Getting a new pet as an adult can seem a little bit more daunting. As a kid, you have more of a carefree approach, where as an adult, you have basically all of the responsibility. Many things have changed over the years in regard to gerbil husbandry. If you do decide to get gerbils as a pet, there are some things that you will need to get beforehand. So let's jump into the gerbil essential startup list. So the first item on the list, and probably the most expensive item, is going to be their tank. If you've seen my other videos, you are aware that I don't recommend housing gerbils in anything smaller than a 40-gallon tank for a pair. I don't look at this like 20 gallons per gerbil, as in my own opinion, I don't think that gerbils should be housed in anything smaller than a 40-gallon, even if it's for a single gerbil. With that in mind, there are many options out there that would be size and cost appropriate. I personally got my 40-gallon tank from PetSmart, and it cost me about $260 plus tax. It did come as one of those reptile startup kits, but the reason I spent so much on that tank was because it had a terrarium lid with locking clips, and that was something that was really important to me. You can also just buy a plain 40-gallon fish tank for about $100 and then get a proper fitting terrarium lid for an additional $25. So that's another great option, and it's certainly cheaper than what I did. Another great option if you don't want to pay so much for a new tank is to check your local classifieds. You can check them for tanks in good used condition, as there are often a ton of them at a discounted price. The last suitable option would be to use an IKEA Detolf, which is about $70 Canadian right now, and then you would just have to make a homemade lid for that. With gerbils, it is also always recommended to have a spare tank in case you get a sick or an injured gerbil, in case of a fight where you would need to quickly separate the gerbils. And it's even just great to have just if you need to clean their tank so that you have somewhere safe and secure you can put them while you do that. So getting a second tank when you are able to is definitely recommended. Plastic and wood houses are not good options for gerbils. After you have their tank, you will also need a water bottle or a bowl or both. I personally use the water bottle that I got from PetSmart. I haven't had a single issue with it. I also use these little IKEA tea light holders, and I do have a topper, so I am able to keep the water bowl in a safe place so that the gerbils don't fill it up with bedding. Speaking of bedding, you will need to purchase a lot of it. To fill up a 40-gallon tank, I use 3/4 of the 49.2-liter bag and the 54-liter bag of KT paper bedding. I also use the 41-liter bag of aspen, and then I add in half a bag of oxbow, timothy hay, and orchard grass mix. So depending on how you set up the tank, you might need bit of a lower bedding area where you can put like the wheel and their sand bath and their water bottle and that kind of stuff. So you might be using less bedding. It really depends on how you choose to set up your tank. One great thing about using a lot of bedding like I do is that it will really increase how long you can stretch your tank cleans. If you've seen my previous video I have on doing a tank clean, you'll know that I never actually throw away all of the bedding. I keep around 50% of the old bedding, so I never need to add in as much bedding as I do the first time around. If I need to, I just add in more new bedding than the old bedding, and that seems to work and be a really great system for us. However, all of that bedding does run me around $75 when I do a tank clean. So hidey houses and bendy bridges are also very important, as they give your gerbils places to hide and they provide structural support for their tunnel systems. There are many options that you can choose from when it comes to hidey houses, but it's generally recommended that you choose a house that is large enough for two gerbils to fit in, and then it has at least two entrances so that one gerbil is not able to block or bully the other gerbil from entering or leaving the hidey house. Bendy bridges should also be large enough so that if both gerbils are traveling through it at the same time, they are able to pass comfortably side by side. The hidey houses I use vary in price and size, and I do use a mix of store-bought ones and like cardboard pieces that I have at home. So it really is up to you, and you don't have to spend a ton of money on that, but I do recommend having more than one hidey house or multiple sleeping areas placed throughout your tank. Gerbils can be sort of finicky eaters, so it's really important that you provide them with nutritious items that also have variety. The gerbil food range is usually around $5 to $15, depending on what you feed your gerbils, with treats being even cheaper. The treats I've found usually are in the $3 to $10 range. Depending on what you buy and how much stock you want to have at one time, that can hike your price tag up a little bit. So the next item is going to be sand. Now sand is super, super, super important for gerbils as it works as a potty and a shower system. Sand is really great at helping to keep the gerbils' coats clean and shiny, and they can also be trained to use their sand as a litter box. Sand varies in price. A 10-pound bag is usually $25 to $35, and that lasts me about a month as I replace the sand weekly. You do want to make sure that you are getting a proper sand and one that is safe for gerbils to use. Calcium sand is a really, really bad option for gerbils as it's super dusty and their sensitive upper respiratory systems can't handle it. You can also use cornmeal, which is a much cheaper substitute at about $3 a bag, and it works all the same. I also advise you to get some sort of sifter as you are going to need to sift out their waste from the sand, and this just makes your life a lot easier. I personally use a 3-pack of them that I got on Amazon for about $15. Now there are many options when it comes to gerbil toys. You can go out and spend a ton of money on toys, or you can just use items that you have at home. I personally choose to do both. I find my boys really like these little kiwi nibbler sticks, and they really love wine corks, as well as any sort of willow ball or rope toy. They just go crazy for those. But their favorites of all time have to be egg carton and toilet paper rolls. So these are likely items that you have at home, so you really can just start recycling into your gerbil tank. So gerbils will also need a proper sized wheel. If you are in Canada, expect to pay around $50 to $100 for a gerbil approved wheel after shipping and taxes. Canada currently does not sell any proper sized gerbil wheels. They have to be imported from places like America or China, which is really, really sad. You can get the 10-inch KT silent spinner wheel, but the reviews aren't that great on it and it really isn't silent. I have owned a smaller version of one of those wheels before, which is why I didn't include it on my list of gerbil approved wheels. I have just recently purchased the 11-inch Wodent wheel for almost $90. The final item is natural wood and rocks. Natural wood is great because it gives the gerbil something that they can nibble on and it allows them to file down their nails, as sometimes their nails can get quite long. There are many types of safe wood that you can get for gerbils and they can be quite expensive depending on what you get. Usually the range is anywhere from like $5 to like $70 for some truly magnificent pieces. Rocks are really great too as they provide a rough, cool surface for your gerbils so they again can file down their nails on it. Rocks can be bought or they can be foraged and cleaned. So there are a few items that I do recommend that while I don't consider them to be essentials, I consider them to be optional, but they're not technically startup essentials. This includes a platform which varies in price depending on the type of wood and materials that you use. My platform cost me a little over $20 to make. I just had to purchase a sheet of wood, really. Having a platform is great. It allows you to provide the gerbils with a deeper burrowing bedding area, and it allows you to have some sort of control on how the layout is in the tank. I also recommend a small broom and a dustpan. This really is a small overlooked item, but I literally use my broom and dustpan every single day in my topper, as I like things to look as neat as possible, and the gerbils do like to undermine me on that. I also recommend getting a hygrometer, as gerbils can be quite temperature sensitive, so it's really great to know what the temperature is in their tank at all times so that you can adjust the room temperature accordingly. I live in Canada, so we have really, really hot summers and really, really cold winters, so it's been really great in knowing whether or not I should put the AC on or whether or not I should turn the heat on and heat up the room a bit better for them, so I really can't recommend that enough. The last item on this list that is optional but would be a great thing to have would be a pet carrier. They are super handy if you ever have to take your gerbils to the vet or if you need to go for a short car ride, or even just if you need to quickly separate your gerbils. So that concludes our gerbil essentials startup list. As you can see, gerbils have many items that they need, and the prices on these items vary quite a bit. The most expensive item for your gerbils will of course be their tank, but everything else does add up as well. The monthly cost of owning your gerbils will be significantly lower than your initial startup cost, but will still run you at, I would say, a minimum of $50 a month, just based on their bedding and their sand and their food and whether or not you choose to buy them any chew toys or not. So thank you all so much for watching this video. I hope that you learned something about gerbil startup costs. And if there's something that you guys consider an essential, drop it down below because I'd love to know what you guys thought of today's video and if you think that there's anything I missed that should have been included on my list. Don't forget to like and subscribe so that you never miss our uploads. Thank you. Bye.